and just to their own souls. On that day when he will gather them all together, it will appear to them as if they had not stayed in this world but an hour of a day to get to know each other. At that time, they will realize that, in fact, the losers are those who denied the meeting with Allah and were not rightly guided. Whether we show you in your lifetime some consequences of what we have promised them or cause you to die before that, in any case, they will have to return to us. Moreover, Allah is watching all their actions. Every nation was sent a Rasul. Once their Rasul came, judgment was passed between them with all fairness, and they were not wronged in the least. They ask, when will this promise be fulfilled? Tell us if what you say be true. Say, I have no control over harm or benefit to myself, except what Allah wills. For every nation there is a deadline. When their deadline comes, it can neither be delayed for even a moment, nor can it be advanced. Say, have you ever considered that if his scourge fall upon you by night or by day, you can do nothing to avert it? What then is there that the criminals wish to hasten? Would you believe it when it actually overtakes you? Then you would beg it to be removed, although it had been your own wish to hurry it on. Then it would be said to the wrongdoers, taste the everlasting punishment. Should you not be rewarded according to your deeds? They will ask you, is what you say really true? Tell them, yes, by my Rabb, it is absolutely true, and you will not be able to avert it. If every person that has done injustice possessed all that the earth contains, he would be willing to offer it all in ransom to redeem himself if he could. They will regret in their hearts when they see the punishment of hell. The decision between them will be made with justice, and no wrong will be done to them. Be aware, all that is in the heavens and the earth belongs to Allah. Be aware, the promise of Allah is true, yet most of them do not know. He is the one who gives life and causes death, and to him you shall all return. O mankind, there has come to you an instruction from your Rabb, a cure for whatever is in your heart, a guidance and a blessing for the true believers. Say, it is the grace and mercy of Allah, so let the people rejoice over it, for it is better than they are collecting. O Prophet, ask them, have you ever considered that out of the sustenance which Allah has given you, you yourselves have made some things halal and others haram? Ask them, did Allah permit you to do so, or do you ascribe a false thing to Allah? What treatment do you think those people will get who ascribe false things to Allah on the day of resurrection? Indeed, Allah is full of grace to mankind, but most of them are not grateful. No matter what affairs you may be engaged in, what portion from the Quran you may be reciting, and whatever deeds you may be doing, we are a witness thereof when you are deeply occupied with it. For there is not even an iota of anything in the earth or in the heaven that is hidden from your Rabb, neither anything smaller than that nor larger, but is recorded in a glorious book. Be aware, the friend of Allah has nothing to fear or to regret. Those who believe and guard against evil, for them is good news in this life and in the hereafter. Allah's words do not change. This is indeed the mighty achievement. O Prophet, let not their remarks grieve you. Surely all honor belongs to Allah. He hears all and knows all. Be aware. Indeed, whatever is in the heavens and in the earth belongs to Allah. Those who invoke other deities besides Allah follow nothing but conjectures and preach nothing but falsehood. He is the one who has made the night for you to rest therein, and the day so that you can see. Indeed, there are signs in this for those who listen to his message. They say, Allah has begotten a son. Glory to him. He is self-sufficient. His is all that is in the heavens and in the earth. Have you any proof for what you say? Would you ascribe to Allah something about which you have no knowledge? O Prophet, tell them, those who ascribe false things to Allah will never prosper. Well, they may have a little enjoyment in this world, but eventually they will have to return to us, and then we will make them taste the severest punishment for their unbelief. Quote to them the story of Nuh, when he said to his people, O my people, if it offends you that I should live among you and preach to you the revelations of Allah, then you should know that I have put my trust in Allah. Go ahead and muster all your Sharaka and come up with your united decision. Plan it well so that you may have no doubt that it is foolproof. Then execute it against me and give me no respite. If you have turned away from my message, I did not lose anything, for I did not ask any reward from you for my services. My reward is only from Allah. I have been commanded to become a Muslim, but they disbelieved him. As a result, we saved him and those of them who were with him in the ark, and we made them successors in the earth, and drowned those who rejected our revelations. You see what was the end of those who were warned, but did not believe. Then after him, we sent Rasuls to their descendants. They came to them with clear signs, but they would not believe what they had rejected before. Thus do we set seals upon the hearts of those who exceed the limit. Then later on we sent Musa and Harun to Pharaoh and his chiefs with our signs. But they showed arrogance, for they were a guilty nation. When the truth did come to them from us, they said, "This is indeed sheer magic." Musa replied, "Is this what you say of the truth when it comes to you? Is this a magic? Magicians do not prosper." They said, "Have you come to turn us away from the faith of our forefathers in order that you too may become the leaders in the land? We will never believe in you." Pharaoh said, "Bring me every skillful magician." When the magicians came, Musa said to them, "Throw what you wish to throw." So when they had thrown, Musa said, "The magic that you have brought, Allah will surely prove it wrong, for Allah does not promote the work of mischief makers. By his word, Allah vindicates the truth, much as the criminals may dislike it." None but a few youth from his own people believed in Musa because of the fear of Pharaoh and his chiefs, lest they should persecute them, and certainly Pharaoh was mighty in the land, and the one who did not hesitate to transgress any limit. Musa said, "O my people, if you sincerely believe in Allah, then put your trust in him, if you are really Muslim." They replied, "In Allah do we put our trust. Our Rabb, do not let us suffer at the hands of unjust people, and deliver us through your mercy from the nation of unbelievers." We revealed our will to Musa and his brother, saying, "Take your people to dwell in Egypt, and make your houses as your Qibla, and establish Salah, and give good news to the believers." Musa prayed, "Our Rabb, you have indeed bestowed on Pharaoh and his chief splendor and wealth in this worldly life. Our Rabb, have you done this so that they may mislead people from your way? Our Rabb, destroy their wealth and harden their hearts so that they may not believe until they see the painful punishment." Allah replied, "Your prayer shall be answered, so remain steadfast and do not follow the path of those who have no knowledge. We led the children of Israel across the sea. Pharaoh and his host pursued them with wickedness and oppression, until when drowning he cried out, 'I believe that there is no God but him in whom the children of Israel believe, and I have become one of the Muslims.' In response, it was said to him, 'Now you believe, but a little while before you were disobedient and one of the mischief makers. We shall save your body this day, so that you may become a sign for the succeeding generations. Indeed, many among mankind are heedless of our signs.' We settled the children of Israel in a respectable dwelling place and provided them with the good things of life. They did not cause dissension until after knowledge had come to them. Surely your Rabb will judge between them in those matters in which they caused dissension on the day of resurrection. If you are in doubt regarding what we have revealed to you, ask those who have been reading the book before you. In fact, the truth has indeed come to you from your Rabb. Therefore, do not be of those who doubt, and do not join those who deny the revelations of Allah. Otherwise, you will become one of the losers. In fact, those against whom the word of your Rabb has proved true will not believe, even if every sign should come to them, until they themselves see the painful punishment. Was there any town which, seeing the scourge, believed, and their belief profited them, except the people of Yunus? When they believed, we removed from them the disgraceful scourge, and allowed them to enjoy their worldly life for a while. If it had been the will of your Rabb that all the people of the world should be believers, all the people of the earth would have believed.